It's Sunday, April 29th. My name's Blaze, and we're about to get right into the drive-by movie news of last week. First off, Bruce Campbell, who was playing Ash in the Ash vs. the Evil Dead, the Star series, has retired the role. He will no longer be Ash. This is mainly due to the fact that Starz has canceled Ash vs. the Evil Dead. It will not be returning for a season 4. It's recently about to premiere its season 3 finale soon, and that will be the end of Ash vs. the Evil Dead. It's kind of sad. I recently just started watching this. It went up on Netflix a couple months ago, and I just started watching it, really enjoying it. But it was on Starz, and that's really hard to access if you have cut the cables and you're a cable cutter. But yeah, really enjoyed it when watching it on Netflix. I recommend anyone checking out. Yeah, it's ending in the next season, but there's at least 2 good seasons on Netflix, and hopefully we'll get the 3rd season in the future. But yeah, I think this is time for Bruce Campbell to retire the role. It's been a long time for him. It's one of his most iconic roles, and hopefully he can move into doing other things with his career. And putting Ash to rest might be the end of the Evil Dead. Next up, Amazon has confirmed that their new series, Jack Ryan, has been renewed for a 2nd season. The 1st season hasn't premiered yet, but I think this might be because John Krasinski is the lead role of Jack Ryan. Recently, his film A Quiet Place has been a stellar hit at the box office, and I think that Amazon is like, oh, we got that guy. He's going to be in our new show, Jack Ryan. Let's go for a season 2. This could be a huge show for Amazon, so I think having John Krasinski in the lead role, America wanting their Jim back, this is the time for a 2nd season of a show with Jim in it. They want to lock him down, get him in a new season before he ventures into directing more films because A Quiet Place was such a success. I am looking forward to this series. I think that it will be interesting. And there's not too many like action shows out there, so hopefully this one has, you know, a big enough budget. I know Jean-Claude Van Johnson was most recently on Amazon, and that was kind of an action comedy, but I hope that Jack Ryan at least can be like a fun action type show. I don't feel like any of the streaming services really have like a good action show. I enjoyed Sense8, but I don't know if that's that much action. It's probably more drama. Anyways, looking forward to this. I'll check it out on Amazon when it comes out in the next couple months. The Stephen King craze continues. Universal has stepped up to the plate. They have acquired the rights to Tommyknockers, the Stephen King novel. Tommyknockers is centered on the residents of a small main town like many of Stephen King's books. They find a strange object in the woods and come under the influence of it. This is set to be produced by James Wan. James Wan is probably one of the most accomplished horror directors of our generation. It's not necessarily my favorite, but I can respect a lot of his work. So I'm at least looking forward to how this develops. I definitely am excited that we are getting more horror movies, whether Stephen King or not. But the Stephen King ones, as long as they, you know, back it up with a proper budget, this being that it's James Wan and Universal, I'm expecting to see the big bucks rolling in budget-wise, and hopefully that will be a good return in investments. So we'll see how this plays out. And just before you thought it left, it was gone, we were rid of it, Me Too, Harvey Weinstein is back in the news. Annapurna and Plan B are set to produce a Harvey Weinstein style picture. I guess you could say it's Harvey Weinstein style because it looks like it's going to be getting Oscars for this one. Anyways, it's going to be a Harvey Weinstein version of Spotlight, essentially. It's going to be, you know, looking at how Ronan Farrow developed the story in the news and reached out to a lot of these victims and how Harvey, you know, took it and how basically everything went down. It's going to be very inspired by Spotlight. And I assume that they're also using Spotlight as the inspiration because they want to center it at the Academy Awards. And I know that Hollywood loves Hollywood. So this is like the perfect Academy Award movie. But for me, I don't know. I think this is way too soon. And it just, I feel like we just live this. I'm not, no disrespect to the victims, of course. I just don't think it's necessary to go watch this on the big screen. We already live this. We're fully aware of what happened. Why do we have to see this? And second of all, the other person who's going to enjoy this the most, Harvey Weinstein. You guys are just making movies for him. Let's be honest here. He's going to be the one that's going to go out there and see it 27 times because he loves seeing himself on the big screen, which is really disgusting, honestly. So I'm not necessarily looking forward to this. I'm looking forward to how it plays out. You know this is going to be at the Oscars maybe this year or next year. So we'll see how this goes. Anyways, guys, that's the news for this week. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Leave a comment. Let me know. Do you think that the Harvey Weinstein movie is a good idea? I don't know. Personally, I don't, but that's just me. Anyways, tune in next week, May 6th, for the news of next week. See you guys then.